Hello students, welcome to Sai Study Center. In the Mental Ability series, today we are going to learn about coding and decoding. Coding and decoding is somewhat interesting one which will relate our number series, alpha and alpha numerical numbers. Come, let's move on to the topic and decode some things. Actually, it is called a system of signals. This coding method is used to transmit the message from sender and it will be received at the other end. But it is passing through some persons also. The third person could not crack it. And the third person could not read this. Likewise, this coding will be done. So these types of tests as given in your mental ability series will judge your skill in interpretations of your data skills and how you are breaking the code to read the message. Come, let's move on with a few other examples to understand it better. The first one is, they have given some code. England is written with some code and France is written with some code. Now we are asked to find out how Greece is coded, right? So when such a type of question is given, you first write the letter, because each alphabet is located with a, that is, it is denoted by a number value. So you are going to relate what is given. So first I have written England. What are all the numbers given for each alphabet? I'm going to write it below. See, E is given as 1, 2 is 3, N is 2, G is 3, 4, 5, again N, it is given as 2. So we can conclude that N is given as 2 always. Yeah. Right. And another one word also given, France. So now we are going to write France. Okay, what are all the letters given for this alphabets? We will write it below. So this is the general method we have to be used, that when some value is given for an alphabet. So it is 7, 8, 5, 2, 9, 1. Now we have to find out what is written for Greece. See, before getting into that, we have given some options also, these type of a question, right? Already I have explained you how to overrule the given options, because we need not to decode all the options given. It can be easily decoded. Let me choose, pick another color pen, then it will be easy for you. See, where is G written? So we can write. Is there any other G here with a different one? No. Then look into your answer. These two are not given, starting with 3. So you can strike out this. Only you have to go with your A and B. See, in the A and B also, except this term 7 and 9, all are same. What is that X, 7 and 9? It is a letter called C. Go with the value of C. What is this value of C? Will be 9, right? So without further delaying this, you can pick this answer. When you check, EE is 1. R is given as 8, E is 1, and C is 9, and E is 1. So without decoding that also, when you relate some values, you can easily find out what, which is the right one in the given option. And remember that, moreover, these type of question always supported with the 4 type of answers. So easily you can rule out 2. Only with the rest of the 2, you have to check if it is any similarities. You can find that where the difference arises, that part alone you crack it. It is easy for you to come with an answer. We'll see another one example of related with some numbers. See, in our next example, this is also some type of alphabet. Previously, we have seen some alphabet. Our name is related with some numerical. Here, one word is related with some other alphabets. Like our alphanumeric, we have to crack it. So here also we can write Sikkim is written as TH. So down itself I am writing. See, this is S is written as T, I is written as H, A is written as L. Wonder, again my K is written with some other letter called J, not as a L. I is written again as J and M as L. So now we have to look into the relationship, how these letters are related. Then only we can go with the crack the code of training. We can write training in terms of code. See, what is the relation between S and T? We can say that S is increased. So S is increased with the one letter. After S, P, Q, R, S, T. Okay. What is I? How I is related? If I is moved forward, then it has to come J. But here, I is reversed. So it is taken minus 1. So it moved here as H. So one step is forwarding, one step is reversing. Now we'll again crack with K. One step forwarded, then it will go with the L. Right, what we have identified is right. So we can go with the same pattern when it is reversed. And M. I to J. It is moved J. One step forward. And L. It's moved reverse. So it is K. So now we can identify that it is uniformly increased to 1. And decreased one. Alternatively, increasing and decreasing takes place. So likewise, we can code T also. If T is increased to one, what will happen? U. If T is increased to one, let close here. Sorry. T is getting increased and T is getting R is getting decreased. So A, first we will write the alphabets. So we have to get increase here. So T is getting increased. Then it should be getting, after T it is U. Then R has to decrease. P, Q, R. After that A has to increase B. Now we have decoded three letters. Now you check with your answer which can be correct. So this one is wrong. This one also UBQ, this one also UBQ. Sorry, this is UBQ, this is UQB. Our answer should be in UBQ. Yeah, right. So the fourth letter, if we identified properly, then we can conclude the answer. So what is H? I will be moved to, it has to move forward. So it will be moved as H. So where we have received with the letter H? In the option of B. Even we want, we can write N to O again H I O F G. So this is how it can be coded properly. So when a word under few letters, alphabet separately given, we have to first crack that given one exactly, whether it is followed any particular pattern to go with the denote that particular one. Sometimes we have to write our alphabets completely, like the last time I have given the tip like that. You have to write A to Z and Z to A. Sometime it will be relating with the forward, and sometimes A is exactly related with Z, the last letter. So likewise also, what is the pattern followed in our code? Using that code only, we have to write the given word in code or given code to crack to find out the word. So now we'll see another one example also. Okay, we'll see another one type of example. In certain code language, 1, 3 means you are well. 7, 5, 8 means they go home. 8, 3 means we are home. Okay, some code language it is given. Now we have to crack what is the particular one represents they. From these two numbers, see in this it is 7, 5, 8. We got a clue that they go home, and 8, 3, 9 means we are home. So in the both the letter, in the both the sets, we have a common number of 8. So we can conclude that it is denoting the word called home. But we have another word also, but no other clue is given. So it is we cannot say that it will follow certain order. See, in the second one, 8 at the end, so it represents home. But in the third one, 8 is in the beginning, that represents home also, because these are the only word which is in both the cases, and this is the only number present in both the cases. So the crack can be at the end time or in the middle of that or in the beginning also they may give. So when we want to crack that, no other option, we can go with that. So if there is another one word given only, because it is a three-letter word, three sets of words are given. So at least we should be able to identify and relate at least two. Then only we can go with the third identifiable one. So we can go with this data inadequate. So there is an option, if data inadequate, you have to, there is a chance to be the answer for that question also. So when anything is given like that, first you have to check whether all the data is given are enough to solve that particular code or enough to proceed with the data given. If it is not possible with the given data given, so you can write that data inadequate. I hope this will be helpful to you. This is going to interpretate your skills. Because of answering these questions, you will be judged how good you are in your interpretation. So practice few more questions like this. And make sure that you are scoring always full marks in this particular unit. If you like this video, please share with your friends. If you are not yet subscribed to our channel yet, please do subscribe SciStudy Center. Thank you, students. Catch you later with an interesting video. Bye.